Good afternoon, students. So in the last class we have started with integration by partial fractions. So in today's class we are going to start with exercise 7.5. In that the first question it is integral x is divided by x plus 1 into x plus 2 dx. So here we have to consider only the integrand part. So let us solve this. So I take up only the integrand. X divided by x plus 1 into x plus 2 into x plus 2, which is equals to, so now this can be written as a by x plus 1 plus b by x plus 2. A divided by x plus 1 plus b divided by x plus 2. So now both the sides we have to take up the RHS, we have to take up the LCM. I write this as it is. X divided by x plus 1 into x plus 2, which is equals to, now A must be multiplied with x plus 2 plus B must be multiplied with x plus 1 whole divided by, we get x plus 1 into x plus 2. So these two get cancelled. So x plus 1 and x plus 2 get cancelled. So from the next problem onwards, you don't have to write this step. You can write it directly because the denominators of both LHS and RHS get cancelled and we can go ahead with the direct. So now x which is equals to a times x plus 2. I multiply a with these two terms and b with these two terms. So we get ax plus a into 2 it is 2a plus b into x it is bx plus b into 1 it is b. So now both the sides we have to equate the coefficient of x and the constant terms. So these are the coefficient of x and these are the constant terms. So ax plus bx can be written as a plus b into x. So here therefore a plus b which is equals to, so here the coefficient of x it is a plus b. So here the coefficient of x it is 1. So a plus b which is equals to 1 and I equate the constant term now. 2a plus b. 2a plus b which is equals to, we do not have any constant term here, that means it is 0. So now we will have to solve these two equations in order to get the values of a and b. So I call this as 1 and this as 2. So solving 1 and 2. Solving 1 and 2. So what do we get here? A plus b which is equals to 1 and then 2a plus b which is equals to 0. So go for the sign change. Minus, minus, so minus, plus b get cancels. A minus 2a will be minus a. Minus a which is equals to 1 minus 0 it is 1. Therefore a which is equals to minus 1. So we have got the value of a. So substitute a equal to minus 1 in any one of the equation, we get the value of b. So put a equal to minus 1 in equation number 1. So minus 1 plus b which is equals to 1. This is our equation number 1. And then take minus 1 to the RHS, it becomes plus 1. 1 plus 1. B which is equals to 2. So we have got both the values of a and b. Now we have to replace these two values in this particular equation. See here, therefore, x divided by x plus 1 into x plus 2, which is equal to, what is the value of a? It is minus 1. So minus 1 divided by x plus 1 plus the value of b, it is 2. I write 2 here. So 2 divided by x plus 2. So now both the sides we can integrate with respect to x. So here I can write integral dx. So here I can write dx, and it is dx. And then now I write this as it is, which is equal to, so minus sign must be written outside as it is. Then integration of dx by x plus 1 will be log mod x plus 1. So this can be written as minus log mod x plus 1 plus 2 must be written outside. It is a constant. Then integration of dx by x plus 2. It is log mod x plus 2 plus c. So now this can be written as, which is equal to minus log mod x plus 1 plus, so now this is in the form of n log x. N log x can be written as log x to the power n. So log mod x plus 2 the whole square plus c. Now this is in the form of log x minus log y. So log x by y, that is x plus 2 the whole square divided by x plus 1 plus c. So this is the answer for the first problem. So pause the video to note it down. Well, the second problem in exercise 7.5, it is integral dx by x square minus 9. I have taken this as I. And then x square minus 9 can be written as x plus 3 into x minus 3. Then it can be written as a by x plus 3 plus b by x minus 3. Next, we have to take up the LCM in the right hand side. So the denominators get cancelled, that I am going to write it directly. So 1 which is equal to, 1 which is equal to a into this term now, x minus 3 plus b into x plus 3. So now 1 which is equal to, 1 which is equal to, multiply a with these two terms and b with these two terms. So we get ax minus 3a plus bx plus 3 times b. Now we have to equate the coefficient of x and the constant terms both the sides. So here search for the x terms, it is ax and bx, and the constant terms are minus 3a plus 3b. So here ax plus bx can be written as a plus b into x. So the coefficient of x, it is a plus b. So a plus b, which is equals to 0, because we do not have any x term in the left hand side. That is why we equating a plus b with 0. So this is equation number 1. Then constant term now, minus 3a plus 3b equal to 1. Minus 3a plus 3b, which is equals to 1. So I call this as equation number 2. Now we will have to solve equation 1 and equation 2 in order to get the values of a and b. So here I multiply 3 to equation 1. Multiply multiply equation one by three. So we get 3a. We get 3a plus 3b, which is equal to 3 into 0 is 0. So this is our new equation now. I call this as equation number 3. So what we have done here? I am multiplying 3 to both the sides of the equation number 1. So now we have to solve equation 2 and equation 3 in order to get the values of A and B. Sorry, this has to be B. Solving 2 and 3. Solving 2 and 3. Minus 3A plus 3B, which is equals to 1. And then 3A plus 3B, which is equals to 0. So we do not have to change the sign here. Already minus 3A plus 3A, they cancel. Then 3B plus 3B, it is 6B, which is equals to 1 plus 0, it is 1. Then B, which is equals to 1 divided by 6. So we have got the value of B. Next we have to substitute B equal to 1 by 6 in any one of the equation, we get the value of A. So put B equal to 1 by 6 in equation 1. So A plus 1 by 6, which is equals to 0. Then A, which is equals to minus 1 by 6. So the value of A is minus 1 by 6. Now, we have to substitute the value of A and B in this particular equation. Therefore, 1 divided by x plus 3 into x minus 3, which is equals to, so A, what is the value of A? It is minus 1 by 6. Minus 1 by 6 divided by x plus 3 plus B divided by, B value it is 1 by 6. So 1 by 6 divided by x minus 3. So in the next step, we have to integrate both the sides. Dx upon x plus 3 into x minus 3, which is equals to, so here 1 by 6, minus 1 by 6 is a constant. I write it outside. Minus 1 by 6 integral dx upon x plus 3 plus, so here 1 by 6 is a constant term. I write it outside the integral. So 1 by 6 integral dx upon x minus 3. Now we have to integrate these two terms. So I write minus 1 by 6 as it is. Minus 1 by 6 as it is. What is the integration of dx by x plus 3? It is log mod x plus 3. Log mod x plus 3 plus 1 by 6, I write it as it is. Then integration of dx by x minus 3, that is log mod x minus 3 plus 3. So it is log mod x minus 3 plus c. So now in these two we have 1 by 6 as a common term. So I take 1 by 6 outside. So we are left out with log x minus 3, log x minus 3 minus log x plus 3 minus log x plus 3 mod complete plus c. So now this is in the form of log x minus log y. Log x minus log y is nothing but log x by y. So 1 by 6 which is equal to, sorry, 1 by 6 into log, we have to write x by y. It is mod x minus 3 divided by x plus 3 plus c. So this is all about the second problem. So pause the video to note it down.